Happy Friday, Internet. Hope you've had a good one. Between your Facebook feed, Twitter feed, and Instagram feed, you're stuffed full of junk food. Too many feeds leads to too many feels too many times. I hope you saved some room for the week's biggest stories from around the world. This is The Loop. The nation of Iran has banned all quote-unquote homosexual and devil-worshipping haircuts, as well as tattoos, tanning beds, and plucked eyebrows for men, as the Ayatollah Khamenei and his supporters deem spiky hairstyles and male grooming to be un-Islamic. This follows a 2010 edict that banned ponytails and mullets on men for similar reasons. Iranian President Hassan Rouhani has publicly come out against these crackdowns, stating that the police should be defending the law and not locking up men for fashion offenses. However, he's been rendered helpless by the more reactionary and conservative Ayatollah, who directly controls the police as supreme leader of Iran. Terror group ISIS has reached a new level of self-parody this week by opening their own luxury hotel in Mosul, one of the first Iraqi cities conquered by the group 10 months ago. You can check out our original story on that here. The five-star Nineveh International Hotel was once voted the finest hotel in Iraq and has been reopened under ISIS management with newly manicured gardens and gleaming marble floors. However, dancing, music, smoking, and gambling are all now banned at the establishment, and all women must dress head-to-toe in black at all times. Punishments for breaking any of the rules range from amputation of limbs to straight-up beheadings. TLDR, stay somewhere else. The United Kingdom had their national elections yesterday, leading to a stunning victory by the Conservative Party, who now have 331 seats in the House of Commons, a majority hold by a margin of 5 seats. The last time they held sway over the House was in 1992. Prime Minister David Cameron returned triumphantly to his residence at 10 Downing Street, pledging to bring the country together and make Britain greater during his next term. He reappointed George Osborne as Chancellor and Theresa May as Home Secretary. The most stunning development in this election was the Scottish National Party's runaway victory in Scotland, claiming 56 of the nation's 59 seats in the House, the highest party gain in the entire election. The UK had a voter turnout of 66.1%, the highest since 1997. In the US, the NSA's domestic phone spying program was declared illegal by a federal appeals court yesterday. The program, which collects bulk telephony metadata on millions of Americans' phone calls, was first exposed to the public in 2013 by Edward Snowden, the former NSA contractor who fled the country and was granted asylum in Russia. While the court did not deem the program unconstitutional, they did say that Congress did not in any way authorize the program, which collects a, quote, staggering amount of information about American citizens. Pressure is being applied to American lawmakers to decide whether to cancel or replace the illegal program, which is set to expire with the rest of the Patriot Act on June 1st. The court said that it's up to Congress to decide whether to permit further domestic spying in the United States. Panera Bread is the latest in a string of food chains to announce that they are removing dozens of artificial chemicals and additives from their food items by 2016. They follow in the footsteps of companies like Dunkin' Donuts and Nestle, who have already declared war on scary-sounding chemicals. Now, I'm in favor of these pushes towards a less processed world, and the removal of ingredients like high-fructose corn syrup and maltodextrin from the Panera Bread menu is highly encouraging. However, their press release is inherently skewed, including both ingredients that they intend to remove and ingredients that they don't use and maybe have never used, making the company look that much more progressive. Panera, please don't turn a good thing into a hollow exercise in health-baiting PR. In People Are Awesome news this week, socially conscious shoe company Toms is celebrating their birthday with One Day Without Shoes, a 16-day-long program that allows all of us to provide children in need from around the world with pairs of shoes. All you have to do is post a picture of your bare feet to Instagram with the hashtag #withoutshoes. Only one photo per person will count towards the total shoes donated, so tell your friends and family. The program is ongoing until May 21st, so get to Grammy. And finally, what did people love in media this week? In music, Zac Brown Band's new album Jekyll and Hyde edged out Josh Groban's new album Stages for number one on the Billboard 200, with Groban debuting at number two. On the iTunes TV charts, Scandal once again had the most downloaded episode of the week, with the Tim Ferriss Experiment and Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. taking the top two season spots. And in movies, Avengers Age of Ultron took home $191 million domestically and $201 million overseas, making it the second biggest domestic opening and fifth biggest worldwide opening weekend of all time, both of them behind, you guessed it, the first Avengers film. And that's everything that you need to know this week. So this weekend, when you're searching for something to say to that girl or guy that you like but you never ever talk to, you've got an abundance of educated and impressive options, because until next Friday, you're in the loop. I'm Matt Lieberman. Thanks for watching.
Apparently, Kylie Jenner has admitted to having something called temporary lip fillers, which is confusing to me because why?
I got school in the morning.
It was just a small job, all right? Nobody got hurt.
Damn it, Hamburglar. You swore you would stop Hamburgling.